And welcome to the latest episode of Articulate Thoughts, which is a personal blog of mine where I share some thoughts, ideas, experiences, and observations about conscious dance, which is a movement practice that uses dance as a form of moving meditation. So today's topic of discussion is movement artistry. And it came about a conversation I had with a good pal of mine who happens to live right over there. And we had a really nice chat, and we were sharing some experiences about some festivals we've been going through. And my pal brought up this topic of movement artistry and this concept of looking at something and interpreting it into a dance. So it's kind of like interpretive dance pretty much, but it was more so from a perspective or an idea of taking something and creating the essence of it in movement. And the experience that they had with it at this music festival that they were experiencing was they were walking by, and then there was an artist that was drawing a painting, and they looked at it and they felt really called to do some movement artistry with it. And so they talked to the artist and said, "Hey man, would it be cool with you if I danced your painting?" And they said, "Yeah, sure." So they went ahead and you know, kind of felt into it and performed this dance of the painting while being witnessed by the painter. And it was a very beautiful co-creative experience, and I was really feeling that, like I heard the story, I'm like, whoa, that's really deep and intense, and in my mind got really deep into that thought. And I was thinking about this, the Bruce Lee saying of "be like water," but then it kind of went to like another level where I was like, yeah, you could be the water, or you could freeze the water, or you could evaporate the water, or add some nitrogen and carbon and make it into like an organic life form, make it to like your own image and likeness. Yeah, so it got like pretty deep there, but I mean, it was just this concept of co-creating out of something that already exists. It's kind of like taking a song and remixing it and just kind of making it your own kind of thing. And it was like a really interesting idea of transmutation and taking things and putting them in a new way and kind of refreshing it, and it still has the same essence but been transmutated and alchemized into something new. So yeah, that was like a pretty cool idea that movement artistry what kind of started. And then I was kind of inspired too, like, I mean, with other things. There was, I mean, speaking of Bruce Lee and martial arts, I've been really into this up-and-coming fighter in the UFC. His name is Israel Adesanya. Isn't that like a cool name? Israel Adesanya. And his alias fighter name is The Last Stylebender, which is like, blows my mind, because I'm a big fan of Avatar, The Last Airbender TV series. And watching Israel fight, I only seen one fight of his live, and I was pretty impressed, because he literally was a stylebender. I mean, he didn't have one particular style form of or another, but he seemed very patient and kind of picked apart his opponent, and it was kind of like watching an anaconda slowly wrap itself around a prey and just kind of squeeze the life out of it. Like, he just took control, dominated the fight. And he actually went on Joe Rogan's podcast, the MMA show, and was interviewed. And I just listened to him talk about different things, and it was just like, the mixed martial arts, it really is a form of movement artistry, but in a form of a combat, and it has the intention of, you know, dismantling your opponent or just taking them out. And, you know, it's more of a violent intention, but it still has its own form of artistry in it. Like, there is a form, there is a textbook, so to speak, of movement in the martial arts. And, you know, you could go to you know, a gym and study those textbook movements and really be, you know, attached to those like textbook movements and just move in a way where like it's very predictable, because the human body has limitations. And if you're let's say you're throwing a jab, and from this position there's only so many different ways that you can move, and therefore makes it predictable. But an artist will see those movements and those possibilities and be creative, and, you know, just kind of be very elusive and be unable to hit. And it's just, martial arts and dance just have this very intimate connection. And in Israel Adesanya's interview, he actually said that he started off as a dancer, and there was a point in his mixed martial arts career where he felt kind of stuck, and he, it's kind of like writer's block, like he the creativity wasn't there, and he just couldn't really put it together. So he went back to dancing, and he started learning crumping, and from that point of view, he was able to, you know, get more in tune with his body, and, you know, release that blockage and move forward. And now he's doing really well in the UFC, and he's is on quite the winning streak and has made quite a name for himself. So congratulations to him, and looking forward to his next fight. And yeah, so this concept of movement artistry is a really powerful thing for me, and I feel really excited in thinking about it and talking about it. And another topic of conversation that came up with my pal yesterday was their ability to really own the title of being an artist. And, you know, it was always like a shy thing, or, you know, like, maybe I'm being too egotistical by calling myself an artist. And during that festival, they were really able to claim that title and say, yes, I am a mover, and I'm an artist with my movements. And I think it's very interesting, because like I felt the same way. And when I thought about it more and more and more, if there's any form of art that I've kind of dived into and I can really own, it really is movement, because movement has always been a big part of my life. And when I think about it, I've actually devoted quite a bit of time into the practice of movement. And I think I was more deluded into thinking that I haven't really mastered myself or devoted myself to a particular thing, one thing or another, because I didn't really, you know, stay with sports, or I didn't stay with martial arts, or I didn't stay with, you know, whatever, musicianship. You know, I was always jumping around and kind of trying this and trying that, and just kind of became a little familiar with all these different things. But I think I've come up to a point in my life where I'm able to take all those creative endeavors and combine them. And now I see that what I've been doing was participating in a transdisciplinary practice. So I was learning all these different things, and now I'm combining them all together into this movement practice that is now a spiritual practice for me. And, you know, it's a thing that's a part of me, and it's very interesting, because it's not so much like a thing that I do, more so it's a mentality and a lifestyle and an attitude that I have, that I bring with me everywhere. And as I go on and experience life, like, there's more of these indicators that this is, like, you know, this is a big part of my life, and it's important to me, and it's a part of my essence. A good example of this was Saturday night. I was invited to a CD release party, and I showed up, and then, you know, it was a guy on an acoustic guitar and a djembe, and they were, you know, playing their show, and a friend of mine who was, like, related to one of the performers, you know, they started, like, dancing on the dance floor. It was just her and another friend of hers, and my friend came over and, like, pulled me in, and I'm pretty sure she had in her mind that I'm a dancer and I love to dance, so, like, I was, like, a good candidate to kind of just pull on the dance floor. So I just kind of, like, let loose and let go and did my thing. And, you know, that kind of warmed me up, and throughout the night, I was just kind of, like, moving, and a little later on, I moved to the back so I could be more open with my movement, and I didn't want to distract other audience members with, like, you know, big, wide movements. I didn't want to take attention away from the performers, so I went to the back and kind of did my own thing. And then later in the night, you know, people were coming up to me and complimenting me on my dance, and this is actually, it's not an unusual occurrence. Like, people do come up to me at, like, you know, concerts or festivals, and, you know, they compliment me on my movement. So, I mean, it's a big thing, because to look at someone and, you know, be amazed or inspired is, like, one thing, but to feel amazed and inspired enough to go up to a complete stranger and compliment them, that's another level. And I think, from my personal experience too, like I was in the music scene for a really long time, and you know, there'd be, like, this thing of, like, you know, I guess a little bit of a competition where, you know, everyone's just kind of, like, eyeing each other out and seeing, like, oh, am I better than this person in whatever way, and it's really silly, really. But I felt really called to approach a musician and compliment them and give them my gratitude if I was really moved and really inspired by their performance. So from that aspect, you know, like, when people compliment me, I take it as a very, like, serious and big thing, and I'm very grateful when people do take that effort. So, yeah, movement artistry, it's a very, very interesting, mind-blowing concept for me, and I'm loving it. And today I will have the privilege of practicing the movement artistry in one of the most richest dance environments that I have found in Calgary yet, which will be at the Central United Church at 7 p.m., with a spectacular teacher in Evangelos Develizis. And inshallah, I hope to see you there. I will put the information on the bottom of this YouTube page. And if not, if you can't get the information there, please feel free to reach out and contact me. And yes, I hope you have a great week. Get moving and check it out. If not, just enjoy your life and be a good person and do good things. And yeah, see ya.